I'm Dom from Cranbourne Music, and today we're filming from my studio, Audiovisual Media Recording. Today we're going to talk about PreSonus Fader Port. It's a single channel control surface that works with Studio One, but also works with other DAWs, including Cubase and Logic. Today we're going to be running it with Studio One 3 Pro. It allows you to operate your digital audio workstation, in this case Studio One, without using your mouse. It also gives you a really tactile feel to mixing. So instead of having to click a mouse, you can actually physically move the fader, put your hand on a fader and move the fader. You can also have it to run your transport control, so play, stop, record, fast forward, rewind, etc. It plugs into your computer via a single USB cable, and as soon as you do that, Studio One recognizes it instantly. There's no configuration required. So it's really easy setup and you're good to go within seconds. As you can see, we have our fader to the left, all right, which is a full-size 100mm fader. It's a motorized fader, so upon playback, it will mimic the fader movements that you've recorded with your automation. Down below we have our transport control, which has all the usual features: stop, play, record, rewind, fast forward, and also if you double click on the stop button, it will return you to zero. We can open and close our various windows with these window views. Our mix window we can open and close should we want to. We can also open various editors and also our browser window. So these can all be accessed via the fader port. It also has an undo and redo, which is really, really handy. So as you can see, it really minimizes the use of the mouse, and you can control Studio One directly here from the fader port. It has a channel select button back and forth, so, and also a bank button. As you can see with the channel select, it enables us to navigate through the various channels in our session. It also has a channel mute and a channel solo, and as you can see, when it solos, it mutes the rest of them. It's also possible, as you can see, to change your volume via the fader. That's represented on the screen in Studio One. So in addition to the fader, we also have a pan knob. So we can just adjust our stereo image of the channel, whether we want it to come out of the left or the right, via this knob. So if we want to pan to the left, rotate it to the left, and similarly to the right. And it's a stepped knob, so it has a really easy feel to it. So in addition to being a pan knob, it has a secondary function, which is a jog function. By pressing the shift and turning that knob, we can navigate to various parts of our arrangement. As you can see, the playhead marker on the screen. Writing automation with the fader port is really, really simple. It has all the automation modes on the fader port. It has read, write, touch, and off. So to write automation, we put the fader port in write mode, play the track, and make our changes. And you can see the automation is being reflected on the screen. So once we've written our automation, we simply put it into read mode, play our track, and that will be reflected by the fader. If we want to make changes to the automation we've just done, we simply place the track in touch mode and we can grab our fader and adjust our automation. Now those changes have been reflected. So as you can see, the fader port makes a great addition to your studio setup, where it gives you a real tactile feel to your studio. Instead of having to press the mouse, which is a really sterile way to do things, a really tactile feel and a real world feel by using real knobs, real faders to make adjustments to your mix. Thanks for checking out the PreSonus Fader Port with me. I'm Dom from Cranbourne Music. We've been filming here at Audiovisual Media Recording. For details, check out the end of this video. And come and see me at Cranbourne Music.